two related poems. The first, a translation of a passage from Virgil's Aeneid, Book 6, translation of lines 297 to 330. From here there is a road which leads to where the waters of Tartarian Acheron are, where a bottomless whirlpool, thick with muck, heaves and seethes and vomits mire into the river Cocytos. Here is the dreadful boatman who keeps these waters, frightful in his squalor. Charon, the gray hairs of his unkempt beard depending from his chin, his glaring eyes on fire, his filthy mantle hanging by a loose knot from his shoulders. All by himself, he manages the sails and with his pole conveys the dead across in his dark boat. He's old, but being a god, old age is young. A vast crowd, so many, rush to the riverbank, women and men, famous great-hearted heroes, the life in their hero bodies now defunct, unmarried boys and girls, sons whom their fathers had had to watch being placed on the funeral pyre, as many as the leaves of the forest that, when autumn's first chill comes, fall from the branches, as many as the birds that flock into the land from the great deep when the season turning cold has driven them over the seas to seek the sun. They stood beseeching on the riverbank, yearning to be the first to be carried across, stretching their hands out towards the farther shore. But the stern ferryman, taking only this one or this other one, pushes the rest away. Aeneas cries out, excited by the tumult, O virgin, why are they crowding at the river? What is it that the spirits want? What is it that decides why some of them are pushed away and others sweep across the livid waters? The aged priestess thus, Anchises' son, true scion of the gods, these are the pools of the river Cocytos, and this the Stygian marsh, whose power it is to make the gods afraid not to keep their word. All in this crowd are helpless, because their bodies have not been covered over. The boatman that you see is Charon. Those who are being carried across with him are they who have been buried. It is forbidden to take any with him across the echoing waters that flow between these terrible riverbanks, who have not found a resting place for their bones. Restlessly, to and fro, along these shores, they wander, waiting for 100 years. Not until after that, the longed-for crossing. The other poem, which is written after the death of my wife, Anne Ferry, is called That Now Are Wild and Do Not Remember. The title and some phrases in the poem are from Sir Thomas Wyatt's poem, They Flee From Me, That Sometime Did Me Seek. That now are wild and do not remember. Where did you go to when you went away? It is as if you step by step were going someplace elsewhere, into some other range of speaking, that I had no gift for speaking, knowing nothing of the language of that place, to which you went with naked foot at night into the wilderness there, elsewhere in the bed, elsewhere somewhere in the house beyond my seeking. I have been so dislanguaged by what happened I cannot speak the words that somewhere you maybe were speaking to others where you went. Maybe they talk together where they are, restlessly wandering along the shore, waiting for a way to cross the river. So, what am I doing inside this old man's body? I feel like I'm the insides of a lobster, all thought and all digestion and pornographic inquiry and getting about and bewilderment and fear, avoidance of trouble, belief in what God knows, vague memories of friends and what they said last night, and seeing outside of myself, from here inside myself, my waving claws inconsequential, wavering, and my feelers preternatural, trembling with their amazing, troubling sensitivity to threat. And I'm aware of and embarrassed by my ways of getting around and my protective shell. Where is it that she I loved has gone? Has this cold sea waters washing over my back? Ancestral lines. It's as when following the other's lines, which are the tracks of somebody gone before, leaving me mischievous clues, telling me who they were and who it was they weren't, and who it is I am because of them, or just for the moment reading them I am. Although the next moment, I'm back in myself and lost. My father at the piano saying to me, "Listen to this." He called the piece Varum. And the nearest my father could come to saying what he made of that was lamely to say, he didn't. Schumann didn't. My father didn't know why. "What's in a dog's heart?" I once asked in a poem. And Christopher Ricks, when he read it, said, "Search me." He wasn't just being funny, of course. He was right. You can't tell anything much about who you are by exercising on the romantic bars. What are the wild waves saying? I don't know. And Shelley didn't know, and knew he didn't. In his great poem, Ode to the West Wind, he said that the leaves of his pages were blowing away, dead leaves, like ghosts from an enchanter fleeing.